Adobe's put some brand new HDR features inside of Photoshop. Let's have a look at them right now. Let's explore these brand new features. We have to enable them. But before I do, let me just briefly explain what is an HDR image. An HDR image is high dynamic range. So here's a photograph that has mixed lighting. We've got lighting outdoors and indoors, and the camera doesn't have enough dynamic range to capture all the detail in the highlights in the shadows at the same time. So we take two additional exposures, one where we underexpose by two stops. This brings out all the detail here in the highlight areas. See how all the colors are now showing. We take an additional photo where we overexpose by two stops, and this is showing all the details here in the shadows. So what we want to do is merge the three photos together into an HDR photograph. So these new features currently are inside of Camera Raw. All right, so we can open these from Bridge or from Photoshop because these are raw files. We're able to open them directly in Photoshop. But before we do, let's look at a setting. So inside of Photoshop, what you want to do is go under Preferences, and under Preferences, go under Technology Previews. And make sure Precise Color Measurement for HDR Display is turned on if you have a monitor that supports HDR. If not, you can still do the feature. But let me show you another setting that you want to have turned on. If you're on Mac, under System Preferences, under Displays, turn on High Dynamic Range. So if everything gets kind of really bright and weird looking, that means your monitor doesn't support HDR. That's okay. Just turn that setting off. We can still do all the editing. It's just going to be slightly different with the preview. All right, now that we've got those set, what we want to do is we want to bring the images into Camera Raw. We can open these images from Bridge by selecting them all and right-clicking and choosing Open in Camera Raw. The other way we can do it is we can open these directly from Photoshop if we choose File, Open, and we can select them. Now, because these are raw files, these are going to open directly into Camera Raw. If these were JPEGs or TIFFs, you would want to open these from Bridge. And now we're going to click Open. Now, you do not want to open these in Photoshop and then choose Camera Raw as a filter, because if we do, some of these settings, such as the output settings, are not going to be available. All right, let me expand this to full screen. Select the first image, hold the Shift key, and click on the last image. This is going to select all three. And now we're going to hit the ellipses, and what we want to do is we want to merge to HDR. So this is going to take all three of these images. This is going to work. We're going to choose Merge. Now, this is going to give us a new image. It's going to save it right next to the original images, and it's going to have HDR in the name. We're going to hit Save. And this is going to be a DNG file. And by default, this new image is going to be selected. So now we're looking at the HDR image. This is completely how everything has worked up to this point. Now, there's a new setting. If we go under the settings, you want to go to Technology Previews and turn on HDR Output. Click OK. You'll see this option that says HDR. Now, you'll have to restart Photoshop in order for these new preferences to take. So once you've done that, you're going to see an option that says HDR. If you don't see that option that says HDR, make sure it's turned on and you reset and you restart Photoshop. Now click on HDR. This is where we start to see some new changes. So first thing, let's have a look at the histogram. On the left-hand side, and where we see the gray, is SDR. So SDR is standard dynamic range. This is a regular photograph. Now what you're going to see is an extended histogram. Everything to the right of this gray bar is going to be the HDR area. This is beyond the visible spectrum of a standard monitor. If you have a monitor that supports HDR, such as I do, you'll see this area in orange. These, by the way, these four are f-stops. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 more f-stops brighter than white. That gray is white and SDR. So this means I've got all this information. I can view one stop brighter than white because it's in orange that I can display on my monitor. So the area in red means that there's detail in these bright areas. We just can't view them on our monitor. Now, there's different things we can do with these bright areas. The first thing is displaying it on an HDR television, monitor, so people can view the extended dynamic range. The other thing is these HDR images, we can take that detail, we can crush it together, and we can tone map it, which we'll do in a second, so we can see more detail on a standard monitor. And then the other thing is if you're working for things like video and 3D, you can actually use HDR content for lighting, for different things. Now, if we want to preview the clipping in these areas, we're going to turn on our clipping here. And if you look at the clipping here, this shows me the red area. There's no detail visible there in those bright areas. The orange area is what's seen on an HDR monitor that you're not going to see on an SDR monitor. Now, we can view the HDR by going down. You'll see an option that says Visualize HDR Ranges. If we turn this on, this is going to show us, and see in here, it shows us these ranges as we roll over. So all this is the regular area. This is all visible. This area is one f-stop brighter than what can be seen on an SDR. And of course, this can be seen on my BenQ monitor because it supports HDR. If I go one more, now we're two stops over. There's detail here. Those are the details that are showing in the blue. Three stops over. And four stops over, you can see that the detail is still going to show in there, but it's just not going to be visible on monitors that don't support that. Now, the cool thing about that is we can squish or edit our images so we can get that detail into the visible range. Before we do that, let's go further. And by the way, this button here can also be accessed by right-clicking and choosing Visualize HDR Ranges from the histogram. This gives us the same option. So the next option is preview for SDR display. If I turn this on, this notice it pushes or crushes this histogram. So all that detail here now is within the SDR space. So this shows people with a regular monitor that doesn't support HDR, this is what they're gonna see. So we might wanna change this a little bit. Let's make it a little brighter. Now, to make the adjustments, we're actually going to make our adjustments up here. This is giving us a visualization. So why is that useful? One, well, it shows us what information is going to be available on a non-HDR monitor. Notice everything's pushed over here. And if we want to export this, we can choose the export option. And then we've got file extensions. Now, if we go under here, there's different formats. There's the JPEG XL. With the JXL and the AVIF or AVIF, these are new formats that are supported by Chrome browser that enables us to output as an image that can be displayed in HDR. Now, if we go down here and we do not enable HDR display, it's going to save it and it's going to look just like it did inside this preview we created. Okay, I'm going to cancel out of here now. Okay, so we've reset all of these. So you can see that the adjustments that we are making up here are actually going to affect this image. Okay, so we've made some adjustments. And we can see this is what it would look like in the SDR. But we're going to turn this preview off. All right, so now we're turning this preview off and let's look at some additional options. Now we can export this image now as an HDR if we choose, you know, an option. Let's do a JPEG XL. And then what we're going to do is enable HDR display. Now under the color spaces, we've got three options. We've got Rec 709, which is used commonly in video for standard dynamic range and sRGB. It's a very small color gamut. P3 HDR is actually the same color gamut that would be used on things like iPads and Apple displays. Or we can go up to a Rec 2020. The Rec 2020 is actually gives you the widest color gamut, meaning that it supports the most amount of colors. So I would choose that. and then we can save this image out for consumption. But if you wanted to rework this later on, save it as a TIFF or a PSD. So use an avif or a JXL if you want to display it on the web and it works on Chrome. Now remember, a lot of applications are not going to support these formats yet because they are brand new formats. All right, let's look at another option. So I'm going to hit cancel. The other option is I can choose to open this in Photoshop. Now remember, we're working in HDR. When that HDR option is turned on, when we click open, this is going to open it in Photoshop as a 32-bit image. So here we are inside Photoshop, and we can tell it's a 32-bit image because it says 32 up on the corner. The other thing, if we click, you'll see 32-bit exposure. So we have an exposure slider that we can use just basically to look inside this image. So we can increase this to inspect the shadow areas, or we could go down to inspect some of the highlight areas. So those areas that were not visible in the monitor, that were in that red area in that histogram, are in the image, and you can move that slider to inspect them. Now, that exposure slider does not affect the image or change it. All it does is change the way that we are visualizing it. So now if we look at Photoshop, a lot of filters now are working inside the 32-bit space. So we can actually composite, we can do stuff in HDR, we can retouch, and while we're in this 32-bit space, this is going to keep things in HDR and fully editable. Now, there's another preference I want to show you. Under Preferences, under File Handling, so this second option uses Camera Raw to convert documents from 32 to 16-bit. So that means when you finish up your editing and you go to convert it, which we're going to do in a second, by default, it's going to take you into Camera Raw where you can make those adjustments. Let me show you how you can access some additional tools. What we're going to do is turn this option off. Now, this particular one does not require a restart for this preference. So we're going to click OK. Now, if you're ready to tone map this or finish it off so we can share it, image, mode, notice we're a 32-bit image. Now we can go to a 16 or an 8-bit image. Now when we do this, this is going to bring up other tools. Now this is giving us an option to merge. If we had layers, you could choose to merge or not merge. I'm going to choose merge because I really don't have any other layers. This is going to bring up the HDR toning. Had we not turned on that option in preferences, we'd be in Camera Raw right now. So remember I made some adjustments to the exposure. The easiest way to fix that is to go exposure gamma, and what you want to do is make sure we're at 0 and 1, which we are now. So this is previewing its true value. Now we could just click OK and that would convert it. But we have other options, and one of them is local adaptation. So this enables us to do further adjustments. Let's take the saturation back a little bit. Now, what's interesting about this is if I move the gamma to the left, it's going to reduce the dynamic range and give us a more natural looking image. So we could open up that shadow detail, or we could close down the shadows a little bit and darken those shadows. Same thing with highlights. See how they'll brighten the highlights, and here we'll recover that highlight detail. Okay, so that'll give us a pretty realistic rendering. The other option is if you wanted to go for a more stylistic, you could increase the detail, and this is where you get that kind of stylistic HDR kind of look. Now, if you wanted to go very extreme, which is not really a style I do anymore, but you know, some people might like it, as you increase the gamma, this is also going to give you more of that kind of grungy HDR kind of a look. And then you could click OK to apply it. I'm going to hit cancel. And what we're going to do is I'm going to go back to the default now, just I wanted to show you these options. Let's go to our file handling. And we're going to go back to Camera Raw to convert documents. Click OK. All right, so I'm basically giving you guys a lot of different options here. Now, here's the last option. So right now we're at a 32-bit image. We have all that dynamic range available. Maybe we needed to use some tools inside of Photoshop. This is another way you could use it. You know, maybe a clone stamp and some different tools, painting tools inside of Photoshop that you wanted to use that you couldn't use in Lightroom. But right now we're still in a true 32-bit HDR image. Now I want to convert this to an 8-bit image that I could print or use for other things. So once again, use all the tools that are available in Photoshop. And then when you're ready to make that conversion, so we're going to choose Image, Mode, and we'll choose an 8-bit image. So we're going to choose Merge once again. Now Camera Raw is going to launch. Here's our HDR image. And we have basically got the same image that we had before, but now we've got any of the adjustments that we made in Photoshop will now be applied. And here we are. This is a true HDR image. We can see that. We can use any of the tools here we want inside of Camera Raw. And then when we click OK, this is now an 8-bit image. This can be printed or shared just like any other image. So what we've done now is we've tone mapped into a regular image. Tone mapping means you take those tones that are not visible and you push them into the visible spectrum to create a better image. So if you look at this, look at the detail that's in the highlights and in the shadows, we've got a beautiful HDR image. And so there's so much more to HDR than what we've covered here. I've got a more in-depth tutorial on basic HDR that I'll reference you in the links underneath. So let me know in the comments underneath if you found this tutorial useful. And by the way, guys, if you're new, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. If you like this, smash the like button into dust. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.